Sagara kulira yo my baby. Kuno mukwano mutofu, nimekupenda bure, bila shaka sikutendi mie. Kuno mutima nga kwa gara nawe, baby kwa gara nawe. So what you want, baby I'ma do for you. Tell me one what, baby I'ma do for you. I'll never let you go,
baby is a promise
for you. So what you want, baby, I'ma give it to you. Tell me one word, baby, I'ma give it to you. I'll never let you go, baby, that's a promise to you. Oh, oh.
Cause my love is for you, yeah, 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 yeah. My love is for you, oh, oh, oh. My love is for you, hey, hey. My love is for you. So yeah, yeah, yeah.
Baby, for you I need a nenga vipenzi. Familia ni vienzi. For you I need a piga haso daily. Ingawa maisha makali. For you I need a piga haso daily. Tujikimu maisha ndio. For you I need a nenga vipenzi. Nita nenga vipen. Baby, for you I need a nenga vipenzi. Familia ni vienzi. For you I need a piga haso daily. Ingawa maisha makali, for you I need a piga haso deni. Atutikimu maisha ndio. For you I need a lenga vipenzi. Need a lenga vipenzi, yeah.
You're the kind of girl I wanna meet. See you walk down straight on the windy day. Take my finger, put a ring on it. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh baby, I find full as a little place. No, no soul team anymore, yeah. Nipe moyo my baby. Usinifanye nikabaki mpweke, yeah. Usinifiche gizani, ukawafuata wenye mali. Oh, nipe moyo my baby. Nipe moyo my baby,
baby
wangu.
For you, I need a lenga vipenzi. Familia ni vienzi. For you, I need a piga haso daily. Ingawa maisha makali. For you, I need a piga haso daily. Tuzikimu maisha ndio. For you, I need a lenga vipenzi.
Nitalenga vipenzi, yeah, yeah.
Wow, welcome, welcome to the show with me, Dominic. It's another week and Merry Easter. I know we say Merry Christmas, but I'm going to say Merry Easter and Happy Christmas. It's that time when it comes. So welcome, and I hope that you are enjoying and you've been well and that God has kept you. It's nice to know that you're viewing the Power Talk Show. And that was Leziki Band. They have been here before. This is their third time, and it's a pleasure having them back. So I want you to be part of today is more of a fun show. Today we're not having very, very long conversation, long interviews. We are actually having more of a, we are celebrating Easter. That's why we are calling it Merry Easter. And I want you to go to our Facebook page and comment there and tell me how are you enjoying Easter. And if you want to say something to Leziki Band, please do. I've got also with me Amos, a legend, Amos from Amos and Josh. He'll be performing, and also Leziki Band will be performing with him. So don't miss this. It's going to be great. He's right here with me. You're going to hear his voice. But for now, Leziki Band, how are you, man?
Fine.
You good?
Fine.
Man, it's nice to have you back.
It's nice to be here.
Yeah. How was your Easter? You enjoyed? You had fun? You went, you know,
No,
for us, Easter, we spent most of our Easter practicing because this coming week we are planning for some live performances. So this weekend it has just been practicing.
Where are these live performances that you are talking about?
They should just follow us on our social media.
Tell them the social media.
On Instagram, it's @leziki. Mm-hmm. In between the letters, underscore, like L underscore, mm-hmm. E underscore, yeah, like that.
Ah, people should not write underscore, it's just
there. Yeah, the mm-hmm. underscore. Oh,
okay. All right, so, I don't know how many have mics, but maybe you could just introduce just say who.
Okay, so my name is Collins Ramsey.
Collins Ramsey.
I'm the lead singer.
Wow, okay.
This is Kevin Ogumu. Mm-hmm. We call him Omwami.
Omwami.
Yeah, he's our songwriter.
Pepu Kuru.
Yeah, he also sings the higher tenor.
Uh-huh.
Then this is Aikotieno.
Aikotieno.
Yes.
Do the viewers know why there is a particular background for him?
Him. he's a Kenyan-Nigerian.
Kenyan-Nigerian.
Yeah.
Oh, I have never heard of that one.
Yeah.
We hear about African-Americans, but Kenya-Nigeria, good and bad of both worlds. That's nice, huh?
Yeah, so that is Andy Muduma.
Muduma.
Our guitarist.
Guitarist, yes, and he's great.
He's also our music director.
Perfect.
Yeah, one of us is missing. He's called Jean. Uh-huh. The sax, the one who plays the saxophone.
Should we search for him? Oh, is he good missing?
He's resting. He went to Mias.
Oh,
it's
okay.
It's holiday.
Then he said he's not going to come back.
Yeah, he's not going to come. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Now, you know what? Music is important for many people,
yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. Maybe it helps them to go through bad times, just listen to some music. Why do you write your music? What do you want people to hear from your music?
So our music, it's basically for true stories.
Mm-hmm.
When you hear lots of our songs, mm-hmm. those are like things that have happened to us. So we write to our song, we write our songs to things that are relevant
mm-hmm.
To the things that are happening. Like this song that you have just performed,
yeah.
Now, it's for it's for you. Like
for me?
No, not for you.
Hey.
The song is called for you.
The song,
the song, the song is called
yes,
for
it's
you.
Called for you. Yes.
So we wrote the song. It was for my for you. You get it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So basically, I was just talking to her,
uh-huh.
telling her that whatever the circumstances. I'm going to fight for us,
No, and something that has just come to mind when you say that, whatever the circumstances, I'm going to fight for us.
Yeah.
Now, we have issues where Ooh. Men, instead of fighting for the us, this relationship, they are fighting them,
Yeah.
So, you're a bunch of men. What mm-hmm. what would be your take for those men who are like, if you don't love me?
It's really wrong.
Mm-hmm.
For you to take someone's life, because God is the giver and the taker of life.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. So it's not right. But I understand mm-hmm. that you may have the anger, the mm-hmm. disappointment, mm-hmm. but you should learn how to suppress.
Awesome.
You get.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So because when what do you gain when someone dies?
So, but at the same time, we need to be better as men, isn't it?
Yeah,
we can
need to
be better.
We can do better.
What do you think, man? I can see you have a mic. Tigers.
As for me, I think just that we as men should just accept our fate and avoid to react. Because for me personally, I said in my life, I will never lay a finger on a lady because these are precious people given, or precious creatures given by God.
Mm.
And for God to give you such a figure in your life, you should ensure that you just take care of her and make sure she's safe.
Awesome.
So the issue of like killing her or doing it's not good.
There's a lady in the house, she's like, yes! Yeah,
we should respect them, by the way, because if we don't respect them, you don't expect them now to give us the,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think you are, by the end of this show, you're not going to be single. So,
I'm not single.
So, your name is, I think, Mike, the guitarist.
Yes,
and Muduma.
Muduma, yes.
Muduma.
Yes.
It's nice to have you on the show, man.
Thanks.
Yeah, so have you ever laid a hand on a woman yourself?
No.
Even praying for her?
That was what I wanted
to say. That's what you are referring to.
Yeah.
Awesome, man. I'll be talking to you during your second performance a little bit more. And gentlemen?
Yes.
You are, what is your name, man?
I am Kevin.
Please hold your mic close to you.
I'm Kevin.
Kevo.
Yeah, Kevo.
All right. I was told you sing high tenor. That's what you said?
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, I'm the composer.
And you're the composer, I'm hearing from the viewers, from hopes. You're the composer.
Yeah.
So now, particularly for you, do you think there is hope for the music industry in Kenya?
I think there is hope because as you can see, there are more talents zinaka. So like sisi kwenye tukukua game, we can see that there are people which wakipewa space and wakipewa nini, they can do well.
Yeah. Perfect.
Yeah.
Now, we're going to take a break. I mean, we're going to pause for a while. And then, so I have a word with Amos, and then you're going to come back. Is that all right?
Yeah.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you're going to... now I'm going to welcome the second guest. That is the legend, Amos. He is here. And before I have a conversation with him, please remember what I have requested you to do. Please go to our social media pages, Facebook. There is already a post there, and you can comment. You know, if you want to say something to Leziki Band, you can share with me how you've celebrated your Easter, what faith means for you. Feel free, go there, comment, and I'm going to be reading out your comments in a few. Right now, Amos.
Hello, sir.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Hello, sir. Thank you for having me.
It's good to have you, man. It's been, I thought you'd come with Josh, but. he is missing also.
He's somewhere walking.
He's walking on.
Yes.
And that's good.
Yeah.
It's nice to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
Now,
Merry Easter.
Merry Easter to you too.
Yeah.
It's a new way of saying instead of Happy Easter.
Apparently,
right?
It's the first time I've heard it.
But Merry Easter. Okay. But it sounds cool, right?
Sounds cool.
Now, how long have you been doing music?
I started singing when I was 8 years old.
8 years old?
8 years old, yes.
And now you're 9 years old. That's good. I mean, it's been a long time.
Yeah, that's like 1 year of hard work, you know? Yeah, but it's been a journey.
It's been a beautiful journey.
Just working with different people here and there, learning things and just the whole encounter that I've had because of music has really transformed the person that I am. The gift itself has taken me to places my academics have not been able to take me. It's actually true when they say that your gift will bring it before kings.
Well, that's amazing.
I have been able to travel places outside this country. I've been able to do a lot because of music, and I appreciate God for the gift. And yeah, I think it's something that he's called me to do, and I'll do it until he calls me to.
He calls you to himself.
Yeah.
Now you're going to be performing a song for us in a few.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What's coming up?
The song is called Mwangaza. The song itself, it came from a passage of scripture that Jesus actually said that do unto others you expect them to do unto you, because actually that's exactly what really happens. Because it's a written law that governs the way we live, that if you do good things to people, they will do good things back.
Yeah.
It's the law of seed and harvest, you know. We call it cause and effect. And if you allow yourself to live your life being a peaceful person, then the day that there's turmoil around you, God will ensure that your life in itself has peace.
Absolutely.
If you're a person of peace. One of the beatitudes of Jesus is blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Because that's exactly what happens.
Absolutely.
If you are a person who, you know, is compassionate to other people, when you need that compassion to be there for you, if you're a forgiving person, the day that you will need forgiveness, it will be there for you. And I think that is the message that I say I communicate through this song, through us a very interesting writing style. I'm a storyteller, and it's the way that I've actually written the song. And
I tell
stories through songs.
That's
so I hope guys have appreciated it. And I think it's the first time I'm performing it acoustic
for TV.
Yeah, in this way. And it's going to be interesting.
Acoustic,
acoustic, actually.
Ah, okay.
Leziki is going to really help me with that. They're an amazing band.
Perfect.
I'm going to ask you
a little, you know, this question of, I'm sure in people's minds, people may be looking at the gospel singers with a huge, not just a pinch of salt, but a huge bag of it because of the scandals and all that, you know? You know, what's your take? What should we expect from the gospel industry? People want to hear music that helps them to go to God. And at the same time, they are expecting the people who are singing, they're singing because they have experienced God. And so they have better, more living. It's not because they have realized that, oh, there is a market for gospel. If I go and brand myself as a gospel singer, I'm going to, you know, have a huge market because Kenyans are mostly still religious. What's your take?
I think as a gospel artist, your moral compass is to point to the cross. And I believe that everybody is, there's nobody who's perfect. Being in the gospel industry does not mean that we have become perfect. And I think that is the attitude that people actually take gospel artists as. They start looking at them in a way that they actually should set an example, which is actually true. Paul tells Timothy to be a good example in word, in deed, in love, in charity, you know. And it's something that is learned. You see, every fruit is a product of maturity. There's no fruit that comes out of nowhere. It means that a seed went to the ground, it grew up, you know, somebody pruned it, somebody, you know, watered that, you know, until it became. And you need to understand that every human being is in the process of becoming.
Yes, true. And you I'll interrupt you there a little bit, because there is your gospel. So there is sin and there is crime. Those are two different things. There is a sin and there's a criminal.
Okay.
And we cannot put the same on the same level, right?
Okay.
So nobody's perfect. Everybody's a sinner, mm-hmm. but not everybody's a criminal. And those are two different things. Should we expect, in the name of not judging artists? Am I putting you on the spot?
No, I love the question.
Okay.
Though you're bringing them up. In regards to criminal, you see, when you're talking about the gospel,
mm-hmm.
the gospel is truth.
Mm-hmm.
You see, truth cannot be. Truth is in itself in a state that cannot be altered. Facts can actually change depending on what happens around it.
Alternative facts.
But truth,
say.
Yeah, mm-hmm. truth is actually what it is.
Mm-hmm.
You see, it's people who believe the truth that actually are set free. You understand?
It's true.
Now, we have a mandate. If you call yourself a gospel artist, you have a mandate to preach that gospel. It means that it also working on you yourself.
Mm-hmm. It's also work on you.
Exactly. Mm. You see, and as I've just conveyed the whole thing, it's you're also in the process of becoming, you see.
Mm-hmm.
So in God's eyes, we are all criminals.
We are sinners.
We are sinners.
Not criminals.
We commit crime. You see, in regards to him, because this is actually, he calls it the law, right? It means if you're breaking the law, what have you done?
No. See, look, my argument is this. There is being a sinner, all right? So someone who sins, take for example, commits fornication, is a sin, right? Adultery is a sin, right? Look, wait. But one who rapes a kid is not just a sinner. That's a criminal.
You see.
And that's not just according to the law.
Saying.
Yes.
This is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
The standards of moral authority are where?
Yes.
In regards to Christianity,
mm-hmm. they're in the scriptures.
Who determines the bar of what righteousness is?
There's the scriptures, right?
Exactly.
Yes.
Right? So if the Bible says, do not steal, okay, do not kill.
Yes.
Okay, do not, and Christ, even in regards to adultery, he said, if you look at a woman to lust after her in your heart,
you've already committed adultery. Yes.
Means that you have already broken that law. Now, if you break any law of the land, what have you become?
You become a sinner.
Not really.
In the Bible, you're using the scriptures.
No.
Don't use
about the land.
You become a criminal. Yes.
Exactly.
Yes.
See, because you've broken the law of the land.
You become a suspect first, though.
Exactly. Mm. And in the kingdom, not really until proven guilty.
Yes. Yeah, you are a suspect.
If you break, because the kingdom of God is a kingdom, it's a government.
Mm.
Okay. And the laws have already been set, right? So if you break the laws of the kingdom, what have you become?
You become a sinner, in my opinion. All right, so I'm going to allow you first of all to perform, and then we're going to continue with this. All right, so Mwangaza, right?
Yeah.
You're coming back for this sinner criminal conversation, and then we talk about saint and prisoner. So I'm going to give you now the stage, perform, and then, right, so there you go. So that's where you will be. So ladies and gentlemen, Amos and Josh. No, Amos, legend Amos from Amos and Josh.
Usitoe mimba yangu we Mungu akileta mtoto analeta sani yake mlete nitamlea Usitoe mimba yangu we Mungu akileta mtoto analeta
sani yake
Huenda kawa Obama atawale Amerika Huenda kawa Lupita Oscar nazo akashinda Huenda kawa Nyerere aongoze Tanzania Uenda kawa makeba Nyimbo nzuri ya katunga na kuomba nerea
Usitoe mimba yangu we
Mungu akileta mtoto
Analeta sahani yake
Lete nitamlea
Usitoe mimba yangu we
Mungu akileta mtoto mtoto
analeta sahani yake.
Kuomba nerea usitoe mimba yangu we Mungu akileta mtoto
analeta sahani yake. Usitoe mimba yangu we analeta sahani yake.
Amazing, amazing from Amos. All right, so can hear some noise in the studio. I hope from home also you're clapping as we continue with the performance. All right, so I'm going to ask you a question from right there, okay. Amos, and maybe even any of you can answer. What's your message for Easter? What's your message for Easter?
You are loved. You are loved. You are loved. If it took a God to die to rescue you, that means that you're loved by the ultimate power of the universe. And that should mean that you should not be discouraged. You should not feel like somebody out there does not love you, because he who made you will understand more than anyone, loved you enough to create an avenue through the death of his son to bring you into the fold. So I think if you're out there and you feel, you know, because we're in a very interesting season right now, you guys are taking their lives.
Yes.
It's a very sad thing what's happening out there. And I think it's because people don't understand that someone out there loves them, you know. And this is a message to you. You are loved.
Mm. Now, let me just, if I may ask something similar to the song that you just performed. So there is a girl maybe watching or listening, and maybe she has made a series of wrong choices. Okay, 2, 3, 4. Maybe she feels she's at a point where she has had an abortion or abortions, right? Yeah. And now here you are saying God loves you, but kama uko na mimba yangu usitoe, right? So how? What's the message, especially during this season of Easter?
Well, this is all of choices, and this song is not like propagating any particular, you know, direction. It's just an urge that if you are in that kind of situation, this is a choice I propose that you make. You know, just choose life and just being pro-life. Yeah, and so if you're in that kind of situation, I'm for pro-life. Yeah, I'm for pro-life. Mm-hmm. The other choice is not really for me. I'm pro-life.
Yeah. Pro-life.
Pro-life means that you should not abort.
Mm. Regardless, there are many other options that exist. Mm-hmm. You can actually go full term and then give out the child for adoption. Yeah, okay. There are many other ways you can actually go through. There are many couples out there who actually have been married for years and they're trying to get babies and they don't have.
Yeah.
And if you have a womb that God has allowed that can actually carry a child full term, it's actually a blessing. And I think you should just allow it to go full term. If you're not ready to take care of the kid, mm-hmm. regardless of the situation or circumstance the kid came with, just allow it to go full term and give it up for adoption.
Perfect. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you for that. So right now we're going to take a short break. We're going to take a short break and we'll be back. Leziki will be performing. So don't go away. We'll be back in a bit. Merry Easter.